Hi there, my name's Ian Pace and welcome to my channel, Pace Creates. This is my fifth video about my fifth ever welding project, the custom chopper motorcycle that you see before you. And it's going to be in two parts. There's quite a lot of detail in this to go through in one, so I hope you enjoy it. If you do, please hit that subscribe button and the thumbs up. Thank you.
Start off with a couple of fork handles for the front end along with a washer for the brake disc. Got a wheel bearing that's been already cut in half for the front wheel. Now a little bit more of a fork handle for the axle. Now I'm looking at the frame compared to the front end, I just think it's too big. I'm going to have to cut that up and scale it down a bit. Now to add the bottom yoke to the front end and then attach the front end to the frame. Now for a couple of handles for the rear end, normally just swing it on, but it's going to be a hard tail, so. Now for a couple of washers for the brake discs, and a bit more of a handle for the axle for the rear wheel. To mount the rear end to the frame. I'm going to cut up a wheel bearing for the rear mudguard. So it's a little bit too wide, and as it's got this high part in the middle, I'm going to cut that piece out and then weld it back together. Now to add some fork prongs to support the rear mudguard. I'm going to use part of these oddly shaped tongs for the seat. So I'm going to take a couple of spoons to cut up and use for the tank. Going to tap the side of the tank with a hammer to bend it round to match the curve of the top of the tank. Now that lines up quite nicely. Now to do the same on the other side. I think it sits a little bit too low, so I'm going to add a little bit of a sort of brace underneath to give it some height. Not that happy about the gap at the front of the tank between that and the front of the frame. So I'm going to cut the frame and make that fit a little bit better. Now I'm just going to temporarily weld this fork in with the frame so that when I try and bend it, it bends it at the right point. Now I've got to weld the front end back on. Now everything else seems to look about in proportion to each other, but I don't like the seat, so I'm going to make some changes there. So it's the end of part one of this custom chopper build that I'm doing. You may have noticed that the rear end of the video is not the same as the rear end in the picture. Coming up in part two, you will see me hack off the rear end and put on a completely different one as per the picture.